made, that's because this was a case of self-defense, a shooting in self-defense, and a case of justifiable homicide. It was really only 74 days later, after this video became public, after the Georgia Bureau of Investigation got involved, that two arrests were made, the father and son McMichaels, now behind bars, facing murder charges. Arthel, back to you.
Steve Harrigan, thank you. Eric?
Arthel, a Northern California beach is now closed after there was a deadly shark attack. Authorities say 26-year-old surfboard maker Ben Kelly was surfing about a mile south of Enresa State Beach in Santa Cruz County when Kelly was attacked by an unknown species of shark.
What got my attention was there was this a very, very large dark fin, and it came out, and it was came out of the water, and then there was like a feeding frenzy and all this activity, and then as soon as it started, it disappeared. It was over.
Well, the area will remain closed until at least Thursday. Beaches in Santa Cruz County happen to be closed to sunbathers. Authorities are still along the stream.
All right, Eric, we'll take it over here. The vice president sharing his thoughts about once convicted Michael Flynn potentially returning to the government. The Justice Department making the controversial decision to drop the case against the former National Security Advisor last week. Mark Meredith has the story.
Michael Flynn's lawyer says the former National Security Advisor was relieved to find out that the Justice Department was dropping the case against him. Flynn had pled guilty to lying to the FBI about his conversations with the Russian ambassador. President Trump fired Flynn in 2017, early in his presidency. The Justice Department recently reviewed the case, though, re-examining what motivated the FBI to focus on Flynn to begin with. Flynn's lawyer discussed the bombshell developments exclusively on Sunday Morning Futures.
He's obviously very grateful to the Attorney General and Mr. Jensen for having the integrity to dig for the truth and to get it out for the American people to see. And he is looking forward to spending time with his family.
And that's the runt. Hi.
Sometime in the near future.
I'm a giant pain in the ass.
Former President Obama weighed in on the case during a conference call with some of his former aides. Portions of the call were leaked out to Yahoo News. Obama said the developments surrounding the Flynn case were being downplayed.
You begin to get worried that basic, not just institutional norms, but our basic understanding of rule of law is at risk.
Democrats are also voicing their increasing displeasure with Attorney General Bill Barr. Two Democratic senators want the Justice Department's Inspector General to review the Flynn matter. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi went even further in her own statement, writing, Attorney General Barr's Justice Department is dropping the case to continue to cover up for the president. A judge still has to sign off on the motion to dismiss the charges against Flynn. Flynn's lawyer tells Fox that could happen as early as this week. Eric Arthel.
Mark Meredith, thank you. Eric.
Well, now the FDA's got some pretty good news, authorizing two new coronavirus tests. This is researchers, of course, trying to race to get a vaccine. That could mean we are closer to getting things back to normal. The lead epidemiologist at Johns Hopkins Testing Initiative will join us about this next on how you can be tested.
Happy Mother's Day to all you mothers and all you mother figures out there. My mom is a proud cancer survivor.
My mother today.
One of my favorite lessons that she taught me was that every day is a gift. And I hope whether you are celebrating virtually or in person, you all can celebrate the gift of the day and the gift of each other.
Dad?
Off. Turn that motherfucker off.
Okay. Now!